She did make it. She is still alive. What's up, fam? It's your girl Q back at Blessed to Be a Blessing, where we are blessed to be a blessing. Let me first say Happy New Year to all of my blessed ones. And for those of you who have not subscribed yet, what you waiting on? Go ahead and subscribe, okay? And while you're at it, I want everyone to go ahead and hit that like button. Make sure you drop a comment below and share the video out. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and jump right into it. Of course, we're here for Queens Season 1, Episode 9, entitled Bars. Y'all, this was pretty good. Of course, I could not wait to get back to find out what happened to Brianna. Did she die? Is she gonna make it? Like, what's going on? Because you know she's played by our girl Eve. Doesn't make sense for ABC to put out a new show, first season, biggest star on the show, Eve, for her character to die. So, just to keep it real with you guys, I did miss the first 7 minutes of the episode. So I'm not really sure if it picked up from last episode where they were all in a hospital waiting to hear what's going to happen to Brianna or not. I did miss that part. However, what I did catch was the rest of the show, okay? And so, it looks like Jill, she's having a bit of PTSD, I would say, because she's been having dreams. She can't sleep, and she just keeps having visions of what happened because you know, her husband got shot in front of her by the police at the chapel of the hospital. So I'm not sure if he died or what. That probably was in the very beginning. So if you did catch the very beginning of the show, go ahead and drop in the comments below. Let me know, too, like, did Brianna make it? Or did they pick up from the beginning and let us know if Brianna made it? And also if Jill's husband, if he died or if he made it or not. So that part, I'm sorry, I don't know about that, guys. But anyway, so that's what's going on with Jill. She can't sleep behind all of that. She's having PTSD. She's not showing up to like practice and rehearsals and things like that. So we're going to pray for our Catholic sister, okay, who's going through. All right, and then... All right, so let's go ahead and move on and talk about Valeria. So Valeria, y'all, she went and got married. I don't know where she met this man at, who he is or what, but they don't know each other. And they ended up just getting married. So she pops up and tells the girls, like, I got a surprise for y'all. I'm married. So it's pretty crazy, too, because now the guy is like, you know, he's feeling her, so he's, like, making all these plans for them to, like, introduce each other to their families, and so she's, like, freezing up, like, oh, my God, oh, my God. Now she's gonna have to tell this guy that she doesn't have a family and that she's never met her birth mother, and by the time she realizes who her mother is now deceased. So she's, like, kind of torn between telling him the truth or not. So initially, she's, like, holding a lie, not telling him, and then finally, she just breaks down and takes him to her mother's grave and tells him all about her life. So he's like, you know what, you do have family. And so he's hugging her and just letting her know that he's her new family, or he's her family. So I hope this really works out for Valeria, so maybe she can kind of like get over some of her superficial ways. Okay, so moving on to Naomi. So y'all know Naomi, she's always trying to hustle. She's always about trying to get that music business going, which I can't blame her, you know. So apparently she's got some news about a rapper that she had beef with back in the day or whatever the case was. Well, it turns out that rapper is played by none other than Remy Ma. I can't remember the name of her character. If you remember, go ahead and drop that in the comments below. But anyway, Remy Ma does a good job. She's basically, her character is now like not in the music industry. She's been blackballed and banned by this big time producer guy, and apparently the rumor was she's a hothead and she got mad and punched the dude. So now everybody's like, oh, nobody's wanted to work with her since the 90s or whatever. So she's been blackballed. So this woman is now working in the grocery store just trying to make ends meet. She's like done with music. She just, you know, she's burned on the whole thing, so she doesn't want anything to do with it. So anyway, Naomi goes and finds her, meets up with her, and is like, hey, you know, apologize for whatever happened between them back in the day. And she's like really wanting to work with her to kind of bring her back out. So they go and they do a song together, and of course Remy smashes it, okay, just kills it, because that's just what she does. And then Naomi's actually singing the hook on the track. The track is hot too, by the way. So I think this cast actually has like an album of all of these songs that they're doing, which would be nice because this is some good music, you know, by a bunch of veteran artists. So pretty cool. But anyway, so, you know, Naomi's trying to talk her into like, you know, yeah, let's go ahead. We can put this out now. And so she's like, no, I'm not fooling with the music industry. You know, she's really burnt on the whole situation. Well, it turns out the producer guy who blackballed her, he was trying to make a pass at her, trying to unbutton her pants or whatever, trying to get in her pants, basically. And because she resisted him, he went ahead and turned everybody against her. I can't stand people like that. But you know what? People like that, just because something you can't manipulate somebody or get what you want out of them, and you sit up and you try to destroy them, you better believe you're going to get your mess back. So I digress. So, yeah, so he tried to blackball her, or he did successfully blackball her. And so that's why she's just burnt on the whole industry. So Naomi came up with an idea. Her and all the girls, and Eric, of course. You know, Eric always trying to get in the mix. And so they decided that they're going to go ahead and start their own record label. And they want her to be an artist on their label. So they presented to her. You know, they got a good sales pitch. She's like, yeah, y'all sound good. Y'all got a good pitch and everything. But how y'all going to afford me? Like, if I'm your only artist, like, where you going to get money from? So they were like, look, Jill's gonna go and start her solo career. Naomi's gonna start her solo career. So is Valeria, and so is Muffin. So they're all gonna be on this new label for women, by women, and it's more of letting the artists have control, more control or whatever, and just, you know, they're gonna work together like a true relationship should be in the music business. So Remy Ma's character is like, okay, well, maybe it sounded pretty good. So I'm excited to see how this is going to pan out. And plus, I would love to see all of these ladies do something solo because they're all so talented. So that I'm excited about. And then our girl Muffin, I can't forget Little Miss Muffin. So she called herself retired from the music industry, right? She's just tired of it because y'all know she's been going through all of these changes, trying to make herself relevant again. And, you know, she's been to rehab, so she's not on drugs anymore. So she's like really getting into who she is as a person, which her real name is Lauren. So she's more so living as Lauren and not really Little Muffin. Well, here comes one of her super fans. Some little girl that's a super fan of Lauren, and she got a chance to meet her and all that stuff. So now the girl is rapping, and she does a diss track against Lauren. So Lauren's like, look, I'm not even getting ready to respond. I'm not getting ready to do this with you or whatever. So Lauren's three homeboys that used to hang with her so tough, y'all, they done flipped and turned on her. Yeah, you boy, people know they can flip. So now they're all on the bandwagon with this girl who's trying to diss Muffin. So anyway, they're all talking junk, calling Muffin. So the girl calls Muffin and she's like, yeah, can you, are you going to respond? And Muffin's like, no, you know, because most nobodies, they do that kind of stuff so they can get the big artists to respond. Now that's going to give them some shine and some light. Lauren's very smart, like, no, I ain't even getting into it because what I'm not going to do is help you blow up off of trying to diss me. Girl, is you crazy? So anyway, the girl pretends and was like, well, can you just like meet with me and like give me some guidance? So Lauren's like, you know what? I can help you. Yeah, I'll do that. So they plan to meet at a restaurant. The girl shows up at the restaurant with the three little boys that used to be Lauren's homeboys, trying to start a fight, calling Muffin all kinds of names, trying to be, you know, just create drama while they're filming it so they can go live. She just tried doing everything to do what they call nowadays clout chase, and she's doing it hard. So Lauren still was a bigger person, like, I'm not going to go there. So she ended up walking out or whatever, which was good. So kudos to Lauren for that. So anyway, after she went to the girls, the queens, and, you know, talked about it or whatever, Lauren's like, you know what? I am going to go ahead and do a diss track. So she goes in the studio and she lays it down. Honey, Muffin came back with that heat. Okay, go ahead and sit that little girl down because she's a nobody and she's not going to be relevant off of Lauren's dime. Okay, so anyway, she did that. So glad of that. So hopefully next week we'll find out how that's going to pan out on the Little Miss Nobody trying to make a name for herself, okay, by coming against Lauren. So anyway, that was pretty much the recap of last night's episode. And forgive me, guys. I am like a day late on that. I apologize. Just trying to get things going for the new year. Got a lot going on, but I'm not going to forget you, okay? Oh, one more thing. I did find out at the end of the episode that our girl, Brianna, she did make it. She is still alive. Okay, so after they all got together and planned to create the record label and everything, they gave her a call. I guess just to kind of like fill her in on it. And when they called her, honey, sister girl was on the island somewhere with her kids, chilling, like on a vacation. So I'm so glad to see that. Okay, so that was episode 9 of Queens. Looking real forward to see what's going to happen on episode 10 next week. So make sure you go ahead and like, comment, share, hit the notification button so you don't miss next week's recap. Okay? Make sure you join in on the conversation too. Let's talk about it. All right. Y'all have a good night. Thank you again for tuning in. Be blessed.